Hi, I'm Peter Travers, and I'm the movie critic for Rolling Stone, here to tell you what's happening at the movie during this wonderful holiday week. And you know, there's a batch of stuff, and I know you're all going to see them because they're meant to be commercial, they're meant to be entertaining. And why is it that they just fall short to me? I don't know why. Well, I'm going to start with the one that you want to see the most, and that has to be Sherlock Holmes. It's an update on Sir Arthur Conan Doyle's great fictional London detective. It stars Robert Downey Jr., an actor who always, always is something to see, and he is here. So why am I pulling back? Well, the director is Guy Ritchie, the guy who did Lock, Stock, and A Million Smoking Barrels, or whatever you want to call his movies, Snatch, Rock and Rolla. He's decided to update this so that all the wit that you had in Arthur Conan Doyle becomes rushing, kicking, chasing, shooting. Downey hardly has a moment to do it. Plus, it's not period anymore. I mean, it's in London and it's in another century, and yet Downey will go see the villain, Lord Blackwell, in his jail cell where this guy scratched things into the jail cell, and he'll say, "Loved what you're doing with the place." No. It's just, what happened? Why couldn't Robert Downey Jr. actually play Sherlock Holmes with the wit the character was invented with? It's a nice idea that Jude Law is Dr. Watson, that everybody's young. They have a little flirtatious thing going on, a kind of bromance, when Watson decides he's going to get engaged to a woman and Downey pouts about it. But it's all chaotic. It's all too noisy. It is kind of dumb when it so should have been smart. So, sorry. Next, it's complicated. This is the Nancy Meyers movie starring Meryl Streep and the wonderful Alec Baldwin and Steve Martin. Basic plot is Meryl Streep's divorced from Alec Baldwin. He left her for a much younger, skinny bitch played by Lake Bell. Meryl is trying to date a sweet little architect played by Steve Martin, and suddenly Alec Baldwin's tired of the young girl, wants his ex-wife back, and she starts slutting around with him. That's it. Well, here's the nightmare for every teenager in America. Seeing a movie where people over 50 talk about sex and actually have it. Ugh, they're not gonna do it. We know what guys are. They, you know, they have to have women in their movies that are jailbait. This movie works because of the actors, but it goes on forever and it seems to be more about the furniture than it is about the story. So I just can't give you the full thumbs up. I can't, just can't do it. Then there's Nine, the musical Nine, with everybody in it. I mean, Daniel Day-Lewis playing Guido Contini, an Italian director based on Federico Fellini and his movie 8½. Now, you know Daniel Day-Lewis is a great actor, but he looks about as Italian as Big Ben, you know, so we're in trouble. But you get to see Nicole Kidman, Penelope Cruz, Kate Hudson, Judi Dench, Sophia Loren as the mother. It's great to look at these women. But it's a hit and miss movie. It's a hit and miss proposition. And maybe you don't want to see Rob Marshall, the director, do that same kind of fast cutting he did with Chicago. If you like Chicago, you'll probably like this. If Chicago made you crazy, boy, you're staying away from Nine. So what can I give you for Christmas that's actually just a good, a sweet, a wonderful emotional moment? That would come in Terry Gilliam's The Imaginarium of Dr. Parnassus. This is the movie starring Heath Ledger. This is the movie that Heath Ledger died before he had completed it, that Terry Gilliam had called in Johnny Depp and Jude Law and Colin Farrell to basically finish the part for Heath Ledger so that when they go behind the Imaginarium, the mirror, it's Heath Ledger on the outside, it's those three actors on the inside. The movie doesn't make a lot of sense, but because it's Gilliam, it makes visual sense. It's just gonna be something that pops your eyes out. But the great thing about it is seeing Heath Ledger, one of the great actors, for the last time. You look at this movie, Dr. Parnassus, and it's a chance for you to say goodbye to Heath Ledger. Take it. I'm Peter Travers.